Hey everybody, thank you for checking out Sticks this month. We have a super fun project planned for you, and this thing on my head is a Viking hat. That's right, we're taking you back to the medieval ages for this month's project, the Catapult. Our goal is going to be to build a cool catapult from a bunch of random materials and see how far we can launch a projectile to hit a target. It's going to be a lot of fun. We know Vikings and other people in that age got their use out of these catapults, but I wonder if they really knew about all the STEM principles that were at stake in these machines. So catapults are pretty old, right, and kind of extinct, so why should we care about them today? Well, topics like projectile motion and elastic potential energy are still really relevant in design today. Think about, for example, a fighter jet, how they launch them off the aircraft carriers using elastic potential energy, or anything that has to deal with getting launched in projectile motion, and accuracy and precision. These are just a few of the examples of the topics we're going to cover in this project and why they still are kind of relevant in today's world. So I mentioned catapults are kind of extinct, but that doesn't mean they don't have a pretty cool history behind them. The first catapults were discovered in 400 BC. That's about 2,400 years ago, a long time. And they were invented by the Greeks and then were quickly adopted widespread across all of Europe. And I'm sure you could guess this, but their main use was for battle and for war. And believe it or not, if you can picture this, how they protected those big cities back in those days is they put up huge walls around them. And puny little soldiers like us couldn't do anything to those walls. So that's what the catapults were for. They would crank them down and launch stuff into those cities. So the first one was kind of an upgrade to the crossbow. And like I said, you know, commanders in the armies, they just fell in love with the concept and just ran with it. And I also mentioned that they became widespread all across Europe pretty quickly. Nowadays, catapults are a little bit too bulky and heavy for our modern soldiers to carry around. But like I said, that doesn't mean the concepts from them aren't used in other aspects of today's society. So as far as what we want you to take away from this project, we've already talked about a lot of it. We're going to introduce you to projectile motion, which goes into what's an optimal angle for things to get launched at. We're going to introduce you to elastic potential energy. We're also just going to keep going with the engineering design process and a little bit more. So thank you for tuning in to this video, and we can't wait to catch you in the next video, which we're going to talk about the STEM principles.